There she is, Vanessa Carlton on Magic 106.7. The song is A Thousand Miles from her debut CD, Be Not Nobody. Vanessa in the recording studio with 68 orchestra members, including people playing violins, violas, woodwinds, and harp as well. Vanessa on piano and the writer of that song. Good morning. You're listening to Magic 106.7's award-winning program, Exceptional Women. I'm your host. This is Candy O'Terry. Vanessa, I've been privileged and honored to speak to so many incredible songwriters. Stevie Nicks, believe it or not, told me that when she needs to feel inspired, she turns on her electric typewriter, Vanessa. She has the same electric typewriter that she had when she was writing songs like Landslide, okay? And she said, and you know what? Sometimes I blow my hair out, she says, and I put on a really cool gown and I dance around and I light candles. I'm not kidding. She told me that, okay? Which is exactly what I thought she might do. Paula Cole,
I love her
too. And Paula Cole is another person you would love meeting. She told me that she gets like a stream of consciousness. She'll just write down little thoughts and she, you know, finds them in her pocket like next week sometime. And Judy Collins, who I greatly admire, says she needs structured time. She has a special room she writes in. She gives herself an hour every day. So, of course, your question, how do you write? What happens for you?
To have that structured thing, that would probably be good for me. I don't ever like to follow a time schedule. You set aside time in your day, chances of something coming out of it are pretty high. But, I mean, I don't put on a gown and dance around like Stevie, even though, God, I just love her. I so respect and admire her. My God. You know what? I'm one of those night owls, and I usually write in the middle of the night, and I tend to write at my parents' house a lot. I'll be home. My mom has my favorite piano. Oh, it's such a beautiful sounding piano. I usually zone out and kind of watch TV. I don't know. It just kind of comes over me. I'm like, I'm going to play. And
wow.
It usually starts at like midnight.
Now, at midnight in the house where you grew up?
Yeah, that's my favorite place to write, yeah. You know, the house is a very boomy house. It's very echoing. And then everything's very open. And so you'd think that my parents and my family would be like, shut up. My God, you're like banging in the middle of the night. They love it, though. They're like, oh, it's a lullaby. You know, I'm very lucky, I have to say. I don't have to go out into the garage or anything.
Speaking of your parents and your upbringing, what is the greatest gift your parents gave to you?
I've met so many musicians that have a lot of problems and a lot of feelings of not being worthy because their parents always told them to get a real job, and that being a musician and playing tunes and putting off college is really inferior to what you should be doing. I am blessed. I can always stretch out my arms, and there's nothing that's going to hold me down. They kept all the doors open. They said, whatever you want to do, whatever you want. And that's like the greatest gift I think parents can give their kids. I mean, yeah, you're going to get nervous if your kid is like 19 living in New York, isn't in school, just waitressing and writing songs. There's not a lot of insurance. But to know that they were okay with that and they believed in me just as much as I believe in myself is very special and I think kind of rare.
Vanessa, when there is an obstacle in your path, how do you get around it?
Well, it depends on the obstacle. Some are much bigger than others. But I am learning. This is what I've learned, especially over the course of recording my album and getting a recording contract and kind of being submerged in the music industry. There's a lot of obstacles, especially if you're a woman. You know what? You have to chip away at it. And if there's like, especially if it's a person in your way, you're working with somebody who you kind of have to, you have certain obligations to, but at the same time, they're preventing you from getting to the next level in your career or whatever. I think the main thing that gets me through is knowing that it's okay if it takes a long time and knowing it's okay if I make mistakes. The chances of it falling through are always pretty high, but it's okay if it does because there's always going to be another way in. There's always another way around it, and there's always a reason for why it went the way it did. I find that every obstacle that I thought that I was unable to, you know, overcome, every time that happened, I would learn one of my greatest lessons. I just realized this over the past year. Obstacles are lessons, and I get around it sometimes or sometimes I don't. You know, you have to be very tenacious, obviously.
Sophie B. Hawkins said something similar to you. She told me the test wouldn't be there if you couldn't pass it. And I think that's a really cool way to look at life. Those obstacles are there because you're supposed to move forward somewhere on your life path.
I agree. I mean, you're definitely not given more than you can handle. The days you're at your lowest point and you're at your most weary, without those days, you couldn't appreciate days when everything's going very smoothly and as it should.
Just a day, just an ordinary day, just trying to get by. Just a boy, just an ordinary boy, but he was looking to the sky. sky, and as he asked if I would come along, I started to realize that every day he finds just what he's looking for. Like a shooting star, he shines, and he said, take my hand, live while you can. Don't you see your dreams lie right in the palm of your hand? And as he spoke ordinary words.
Magic 106.7 with Vanessa Carlton. That's Ordinary Day from her CD Be Not Nobody on Interscope Records. Take my hand, live while you can. Don't you see your dreams lie right in the palm of your hand? Hi, this is Magic's Candy O'Terry, and you're listening to the award-winning program, Exceptional Women. You were mentioning some of the obstacles have been tough for you in the music business as a woman. What is woman power to you?
If you're in a meeting with all men, you're the only woman, I think you have more power than all the men put together. It's a very strange thing. Men are very intimidated, and trying to figure out what makes them so intimidated, I have a feeling, besides the fact that there's a very intense female energy, I think every woman has it. I don't know if every woman taps into it, but it's very intense. And I don't mean to sound women are superior to men, because I don't think they are, but they definitely have this knowledge. I don't know if it's a spiritual thing or if it's like a social thing. I just feel like women know these secrets, and they have a greater understanding of the way things work sometimes than any other creature on earth. I think it is. I think it's like this basic understanding. It's so hard for me because I think I'm still coming into it.
You are,
I'm only
sure.
21, and I think, you know, you asking the same question 20 years from now, it's going to be obviously a bit more refined and eloquently spoken. I just know that I have a strength and an understanding. A lot of my incredible female friends, they have it too. I think it's hard to find anywhere else but in a woman.
You had mentioned if I asked you this question in 20 years, it might be more clearly defined. Mm-hmm. Let's just flash forward 10 years from now. Where do you hope you are in your life? What is your goal?
I have a lot of different goals. I want to go to Columbia and record records. Everyone's like, how are you going to do both at the same time? How are you going to get a degree at the same time? Blah, blah, blah. I plan by 30. I promised my mom and she'll kill me if this doesn't happen. I plan on having a degree. I want to have a family. I mean, I don't know, 30, probably 30, and then I'll just start thinking about that stuff. But I kind of want it all. By the time I'm 30, I think I'll have been through a lot and have grown a lot musically and just as a person.
Yeah.
I already have over the past couple of years just recording this album. Already, I'm so excited to do my next album. You know, I just feel like it's kind of going in my own minute. I'm always looking forward. I always am.
And don't forget to sit back and enjoy some of it, because I know that you're probably pulled in so many different directions.
I am, but I'm home base. I know that. I'll never forget that. There's many different directions that I'm pulled in. I only go where I want to go. I start to not enjoy it. It's just not worth it. You have to fill your days with stuff that fulfills you.
And that's Exceptional Women for this week. If you know someone who has beaten the odds even in the toughest of times, someone who is a role model for those around her, we'd love to hear her story. Check out our website, magic1067.com, and click on Exceptional Women. Thanks so much to Vanessa Carlton, who allowed us to shine the spotlight on her. This is Magic's Candy O'Terry. Join my radio partner, Gay Vernon, and me every Sunday morning at this time for Exceptional Women. Radio portraits of women who will inspire you.